Can you hear me?
Chris Brien here. They're still on the shuffle ostinato. A pattern we haven't looked at is the African six. I'll play an African six, then I'll show you how you can apply this to the instrument. Again, it's a pattern that most people don't know, and it's all over the internet once you know what it is. This is an African six. 2, 3, 4. It's one of endless ways of playing it. You could do a double backbeat, I suppose. 2, 3, 4. So I'm going to take this concept, this melody, and put that over the shuffle ostinato, and we'll go through it. Again, it's all in my book, Progressor. It's all in this book. It's all in this book. There you go. It's in that book. Get a copy of that book. Now, so we're playing here. We're playing a shuffle ostinato. Go through the other lessons before you do this, otherwise you're going to probably get confused. So you got this going. I'm going to play on the one. I'll do it on the snare so it's clear. Clear it first. One, and four time. 2, 3, 4. One, One, Then two, and a. One, and a. And then three, and. The and of three. On the four. And then the art, and then you loop the art of four and you loop it. And then you up the tempo, and you're going to correct my headphones, you'll get this. So a nice exercise to do is to play that for three bars, fourth bar, play one of your permutations, create some music. Let's go. One, two, three, four. Again, the possibilities are endless. So the African six, and the actual sticking pattern, again, it's in my book, Progressive Rhythms. It's similar to a double paradiddle. A double paradiddle would be right, left, right, left, right, right, left, right, left, right, left, left. If you don't know that, again, get a drum teacher to show you that, because it's a really basic thing. So instead of going right, left, right, left, right, right, left, right, left, right, left, left, the African six is right, left, right, left, right, right, same. Left, right, left, right, left, right. So you have this one come back to it. You hear like R&B guys, you know, playing that in their solos and stuff. It's a fairly basic thing. I've seen some guys on the internet saying they're doing Mozambique. Who are doing that? It's not a Mozambique, that's an African six. But they want to call it Mozambique? Awesome, I don't really care. None of my business what they think. So it's an African six. Maybe I'm wrong, I don't know. And understand, I'm self-taught, I'm a percussionist, I'm not a drummer. I can play drums, of course, otherwise I wouldn't be here. But I'm a percussionist. I play percussion as well as I play drum set. I play many instruments, bit of sax, bass guitar, bit of keyboards, whatever. My main thing is drum set and percussion. I was basically self-taught, had a couple lessons when I was very young. One teacher went to university, the next one died. It was like, okay, this is not happening. So I taught myself, percussion self-taught, and I just learned, the people who taught me all the Latin percussion stuff were actually Latin percussionists from Uruguay. They were street percussionists in Sydney in the 1990s. They taught me the rumba encore, the merengue, the cascara, all this sort of rhythms and stuff, which I'd never heard of. And it's a lot of that stuff I'm doing now. African six I got from them. But there was no formal lessons. I was playing in bands with them. They say, Flaco, you play African six here. No, Mozambique. And you play like with your fist. It was just amazing tuition. Anyway, so street tuition. Anyway, so that's the African six. that format. Okay, so I'm now going to play these permutations to a rock beat. I'm not going to go through every permutation. The videos go too long. No one's going to watch it. Not even my mother would watch that. So I'll apply them to the rock beat. Thank you. Chris Brien, over and out. Had to do it one more time. We'll do that. Bye-bye.